Hello everyone. In this video, I am going to explain the calculation of funds from operations, which is a requirement for preparing funds flow statement. I have already released another video on calculation of funds from operations. If you have not watched that video, look at the description down here to find the link for the first video. Watch that video as well to gain better understanding on this concept. Now let's discuss the problem which is given in the form of profit and loss account. In the debit side of profit and loss account, as usual, you find the indirect expenses and losses are debited. In the credit side, you find indirect incomes like interest on investment, profit on sale of machinery are credited. You find gross profit and net profit that are calculated and shown in the problem. Now, among these expenses, we should identify the non-operating or non-fund or non-operating and non-fund expenses. In the credit side, we should identify the indirect incomes, the non-operating incomes or non-fund incomes. We have to identify them and do the adjustments with the net profit so that we could calculate the funds from operations which could otherwise be called as operating profit, which lies in between gross profit and net profit, which lies and over here. Now, among the expenses listed down in the debit side of the P&L account, you find administration expenses. Administration expenses and selling expenses both are operating as well as fund expenses. Therefore, we should not reverse them. We should not consider them for adjustment with the net profit to calculate funds from operations. I have explained them in detail in the first video. The third one is about depreciation. Depreciation is an operating expenditure, but it is a non-fund expenditure. Since it fulfills that criteria, it has to be reversed. It is a non-fund expenditure which was deducted from gross profit to calculate net profit to be again added back with the net profit to calculate the funds from operations. Then loss on sale of building. It is a non-operating loss. And it is also a non-fund loss. It has to be reversed and added with the net profit. The next one is about goodwill written off. Goodwill written off is a book entry. It is a non-operating and non-fund expenditure to be added back with the net profit. It doesn't result in increase or decrease in funds. Discount on issue of debentures. It is also a non-operating activity. Therefore, that should also be added with the net profit. What about the incomes? Any income which is credited in the P&L account is a non-operating income. So the non-operating incomes which were added with the gross profit to calculate net profit to be subtracted to find out the funds from operations or operating profit. This is what I have explained already, and the same point I emphasize upon in this video as well. So what are the items to be added with the net profit, added back with the net profit? The non-operating or non-fund or non-operating and non-fund expenses to be added back. The non-operating incomes are to be subtracted from the net profit so that we go back a step and find out the middle figure in between GP and NP, which is nothing but operating profit or funds from operations. Now look at the solution quickly. As usual, the starting point for this statement showing funds from operation is the net profit. Net profit for the year 1,44,000. With that, which items are added? What is the heading given in the solution? Items which do not decrease funds from operations but debited to P&L account. As I said in the first video also, these items were debited in the P&L account. It was correct. It was correct to calculate the net profit, but it is not correct to calculate the operating profit. And that is why the items, the odd items which were deducted or debited in the P&L account to calculate net profit are added back with the net profit to find out the funds from operations. Those items we discussed in detail just now. They are depreciation, non-fund expenditure, loss on sale of building, non-operating and non-fund expenditure, goodwill written off, non-operating and non-fund expenditure, discount on issue of debentures, it is a non-operating expenditure. All these items are added and you have come to know the total of 39,000, which is added with the net profit, and get the total of 1,83,000 in this stage. Now, what is the next step in the calculation of funds from operations? Items which do not increase funds, though they are income, they are not going to increase the funds from operations. That is not important. Funds from operations, but credited to P&L account. All, as I say continuously, all indirect incomes are what? Non-operating incomes. They have to be subtracted from the net profit so that you come to know the operating profit or funds from operations. See, the two items, 5,000 rupees, 4,000 rupees, put together 9,000, and that is subtracted from 1,83,000, you have calculated 1,74,000 as a funds from operations. This is very simple. And again, I tell you, since you are given with the gross profit, you can follow other method as well. What is the method? If you start from gross profit, you subtract only the other operating expenses debited in the P&L account, you will get the same answer of funds from operations. You calculate it at your own from the explanation what I give now. Take the starting point gross profit 2,15,000 in the second method. Subtract the other operating expenses like administration expenses, selling expenses. These two expenses are to be subtracted. That comes to 41,000. From 2,15,000, if you subtract 41,000, it comes to the same answer what you arrive here. The 1,74,000 could be calculated. This is another method by which you can calculate funds from operation if you find gross profit also is also given in the problem. So thanks for watching this video. And if you have not watched the first video, please watch it. And watch this video once again, you will gain clear understanding of the calculation of funds from operations. There are few other items which we have not considered in the two problems. The items like transfer to general reserve, transfer to sinking fund. See, these items are all the non-fund or non-operating expenses. So these items have also to be added with the net profit to calculate funds from operations. So thanks for watching the video. We'll see in the next video.